If the Indians are crazy about something after cricket, it has to be the news. Well, if you want to skip the controversial part, let me tell you, there's no escaping. The news throughout the country is right available on your social media feed. There was a time when newspaper was the only source of authenticity present through for the news. But with the introduction of social media platforms and the access of phones to everyone, speaking news is available right at your fingertips. So that does leads us to the question, which one is the real and which one is the fake?
And this is your co-host Zena, and welcome to Map of Me Morning Show. Map of Me is a digital platform that helps young men and women aged around 18 to 25 get a head start in their career by using their creativity.
And well, you know what? It also enhances different skills of yours and also enables you to take part in different competitive exams like NEET, MBBS, and so on.
And you can also come and, you know, get a head start on your soft skills such as your teamwork, your creativity.
So, don't forget to log into www.mapofme.in and be a part of our family to participate in different quiz, watch all the episodes and be a part.
Dude, you know what I read in the papers this morning? It pretty much said that the Earth is going to be a hothouse in the next 20 years. You have any idea how high the temperature is going to go up?
Well, you see, climate change is actually a global crisis. Mm. But how can you really think which one is the truth and which one the fake?
Yeah, that's right. I guess we're going to have to find out about that in today's episode. But first, how about we go and see just how very concerned today's youth is about climate change. And you know what? Maybe we're even going to find someone out there who's doing something entrepreneurial that can actually help us, you know, with the whole climate crisis.
Well, you see, the youth of the country is actually very concerned and aware. That is what I've read from the resources. So, you know what? Let's go and have a talk with them to understand how much they are concerned about the news and the climate change.
Right, let's go.
So, do you read newspapers?
Yeah, I do. Mostly on social media, generally, on e-newspapers, not the hard
copy. So, what is the type of, or what brand, company do you read?
Basically, ET. I use ET and then sometimes Telegraph and T2 just for the fun pages and all.
If we can ask you all about the news if you read, and if you read, do you prefer a phone or the authentic newspaper, and what is your favorite section?
Phone gives everything. Like phone has all the details, what we need, whatever regarding beauty, regarding any news, like anything, phone is just handy, and that is the best thing, I think.
I prefer both. Because my father is very news Nazi, so yeah. I personally prefer both, but phone is all time favorite.
Well, you see how beautifully the people of Kolkata are aware and knowledgeable about what's happening in and around. But in the era of 2021, news, media and entertainment is available right in our fingertips. So what really leaves us to the question is how much of them is fake and how much of them is real. So let's meet experts of the show today and see what they have to say about this.
Hello ma'am. Hi. Could you introduce yourself to us? What do you do?
Hi, I'm Shamoita.
Yeah.
I work with Calcutta Times, Times okay. of India. I came back to Calcutta in 2016 and okay. ever since I've been working with Calcutta Times.
Okay, so how long does your journalism career span? Like, how long have you been practicing it for?
Well, it has been almost 11 years now. Okay. I did my master's in international journalism from okay. Cardiff University.
Okay.
And after that, it was ages ago.
Okay.
And after that, I started working in London okay. in a very small newspaper.
Okay.
I worked there for a couple of years, for 3-4 years. And okay. then I got back to Calcutta for about 20 months. I worked in a okay. news channel. And then I moved to Bangalore in 2013.
Okay.
And there I started working with Times of India Group. Okay. I used to work in Bangalore. And then I took a transfer. I came down to Calcutta.
Okay. So, as a well-versed person in journalism, I want to ask you, where do you collect your facts, your information from while you present a story, report a story?
So, I mean, like any journalist, I would rely on the source.
Okay.
And so when I say source, it's not necessarily the anonymous source. It is usually, I work in an entertainment field, as you can Calcutta Times. Calcutta, if you know about Calcutta Times, definitely. You know in entertainment, lifestyle and everything like that. So we talk to people concerned, people who are directly, you know, the stars, the directors, the actors, the music directors.
Okay.
We talk and we gather information. That is our primary source of information.
Okay.
And then, of course, we have our sources in the industry.
Okay.
We talk to them, get in touch with them every now and then.
Okay.
And that's how we gather information.
Okay. How important do you think fact-checking is in your profession?
I think that is the most important thing, really, if you think about it. See, our job is to gather information and present it to our audience.
Yeah.
So a large number of population actually depend upon us when it comes to knowing about what is going on.
True.
So how can, you know, facts, how can you go wrong with facts that you are presenting?
So, my next question is a follow-up. How do you perform fact-checking while you are?
So, see, when it comes to a direct source, for example, in my profession, I can tell you somebody is saying that I'm getting married.
Okay.
Anyone is saying I'm getting married. If that person is admitting that he or she is getting married, then it is a
valid source.
It's a valid source. Yeah. It's a first person account.
True.
If it is not, if somebody else is giving me this information that Mr. X is getting married to Miss Y, then for me the benchmark is I will at least try to cross-check through two different very reliable sources.
Okay.
If possible, I will definitely check it with the people concerned.
Okay.
That is Mr. X and Miss Y.
Yeah.
So, in your contacts, your sources, need to be very, very authentic. You will really have to trust your sources.
Okay.
They really, they need to be very reliable, really, and be one phase of fact checking is never enough.
Okay.
So you go to your next step and do your fact checking again. This is for the direct information.
Okay.
And yes, I mean that is about it.
Okay. Has it ever happened with you in a hypothetical situation where a reader or consumer of your story has accused your story of fake news?
No. As of now, no.
Okay.
So there is a very simple thumb rule that I tend to follow. I do not know whether it is the best thing to follow.
Okay.
I would much rather not write, not tell a story that I'm not 100% sure of.
Okay.
I would rather let that go.
Okay.
Then I would rather hold that back than presenting something which is
untrue,
which is not true.
Yeah.
I think that is what I do. So out of 100 stories, you probably give a couple of stories a miss.
Yeah.
Which is avoidable.
True.
Try and avoid that, but it is better than you know, losing your credibility to your readers.
True.
One small slip, one small wrong thing, one small wrong information. Your editors, your colleagues, your editor, your readers, most importantly, your readers will not trust you anymore.
True.
Now, that is very tricky. So, there you take a call. You will have to be 100% sure while you're writing a story, while you're telling a story. Really. It doesn't matter whether you're writing, you're saying it aloud, or you're broadcasting it on radio, or you're writing it on internet, doesn't matter. You have your set of readers.
Definitely. My last question to you is, what do you think are five ways that you can enlist that would help somebody understand that this is a fake news story? Any number of ways that you can tell that this is a fake news story and this is not, or something that is evident that this is fake news.
I don't know if I can give you five ways. Okay. I can tell you this, that when I was studying journalism, I was told, I can't remember by whom, but I was told that if something appears to be too good to be true or too bad to be true, it usually is.
Okay.
So I would think that, you know, don't give in to speculation. Don't give in, don't jump and believe something that sounds like there can be some agenda behind it. Also, if you are reading one story from one source, chances are there will be other version of it too. In other, unless it is like a super breaking story that only one has got and the other people are yet to get. But before you believe in and react to it, I mean, you might read something, you might see something, you might watch something, you might hear something. But before you actually believe in and react to the story, be sure that it is true.
Definitely.
That I think is very important.
Okay, okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
This priceless advice from you is, it's really appreciated by our viewers.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for your time. Thanks for choosing me.
Yeah.
न्यूज़पेपर पढ़ते हैं कि नहीं, और अगर पढ़ते हैं तो फोन में पढ़ते हैं या फिर न्यूज़पेपर के थ्रू?
फोन में कभी कभी पढ़ लेते हैं, वो न्यूज़पेपर घर पे नहीं आता अभी, नहीं आता।
अच्छा। मैं फोन पे ही पढ़ लेता
हूं। We wanted to ask if you read news and if you do, is it the phone or is it the newspaper?
As you said, it's youth. So therefore we prefer mobiles more, because it's easily accessible.
Do you think it's effective?
Yeah, it's effective. As because nowadays Instagram is very, very much into this news and all, like recently, back when when lockdown was there, many social news were was there in Instagram only. So therefore, in Instagram is a nice place to have these news. So I'll say mobile. My vote is for mobile.
The same goes for me especially. You know, people have digitalized themselves, and mainly on social media platforms, they have put up a lot of efforts in providing and spreading awareness to the people around here. So yeah, basically. And you know, Instagram and Facebook, they provide a lot of news, as he said.
Yeah, it's good to have papers. Newspapers is also important. But having something live is also very effective, right? Because it's connect with you emotionally.
Ma'am, if you could tell us, if you read newspaper and if you do, would you prefer a phone or the authentic paper?
We prefer phone. I would prefer both newspaper or phone.
Okay. So, which is the most interesting section when you go, when you hear the word news? Is it Bollywood? Is it current affairs? Oil market?
Bollywood, no doubt. Current affairs.
So welcome to Map of Me. Ma'am, if you could please introduce yourself.
This is Anushwa Basu. I am a Calcutta-based journalist. I work for The Telegraph, an English newspaper that is published from Calcutta. I have over 30 years of experience and I have worked across a number of beats in journalism, print journalism. Thank you.
How are you this evening?
I'm good. I'm trying to be good. Thank you. How are you?
I'm good, ma'am. Thank you. Well, if you could tell our audience the publication you work for, where do you get this information from?
So I work for The Telegraph, which is an English paper that is published by An Bazaar Group. It is the company incorporated as AVP Limited. And it is an English newspaper that has been coming out of Calcutta, printed in Calcutta since 1982.
Thank you.
How do we source our news? There are various institutions from where we source our news. Firstly, there is the news agencies, the PTI, UNI, Reuters, Agency France Press, etc., international as well as national. Plus, we have our own Bureau of Reporters. So we have a huge Bureau of Reporters based out of Calcutta. We have a huge Delhi Bureau. We have bureaus all over the country, Delhi, Chennai, Bombay, and also in the Northeast, everywhere across India.
Thank you, ma'am. If you could, you know, throw a little light on fact-checking and tell our viewers of Map of Me about it a little.
Fact-checking has become very important these days. primarily because of the kind of news which don't carry much authenticity. So that is why it is very important that we double check whatever we are printing or broadcasting or putting it out on websites. How do you do fact checking? If that is your question, then yes, there are a lot of ways that you can do. Number one, the main thing is to go back to the primary source, which in case of an interview, if you're interviewing someone, you should cross check every, you should personally record your interviews. So there is always a data, your source, authenticated source there, and attribute your source, whoever said so and so. So that is one way of guarding against false facts. So, and you should also tell your interviewer that, you know, you should be very careful of what you are saying. There have been plenty of cases where they have retracted what they said later. Number two is go back to primary sources, as in go back to books. If you're referring to books, encyclopedias, they should be of repute. They, again, you can, you know, you have a variety of printed material where you can go back to. If it's not books and if it's websites, you have to basically go to reputed websites which have very good ratings and source your facts from there. These are some of the you know, safeguards that you can adopt.
So in this era of, you know, being accused of fact-checking and everything, so how does it feel when one gets accused of fact-checking as such?
You can't be accused of fact-checking.
Okay.
So you can be accused of false
yes,
news,
ma'am.
Or, you know, so obviously it's not a very good feeling, and sometimes you fall prey to it because you know, in this age where of website news and you know, where you know, the race is to put news first ahead of everyone else,
right.
Then it's sometimes just not possible to, you know, double check and double check. But print is safeguarded from that because you have the entire day to cross check, and that is why, you know, these days there's a lot of you know, say about the print being more verifiable, the print being more authentic, and so on and so forth. So, yes, you should take your time and, you know, cross-check your facts before you put it out into the public domain.
So, ma'am, as a journalist, if you could please tell us how, you know, journalists fall into the hands of false and fake news.
So, I'll give you a real-world example as it happened in, it was during the farmers' movement in Delhi, the Delhi borders, where you know, farmers had gathered and there was a whole congregation. And there was this particular farmer, I believe he was from, he was an NRI. He was in the forefront of the movement, and he was riding his tractor into the barricades that the police had set up. And he drove his tractor right through the barricades and met with an accident, and he died. So the first on Twitter was a very reputed journalist, I will not name him, from a very reputed channel, to say that you know, a farmer protester died of police firing, which was not the case. He died of injuries because of the tractor rolling, you know. So he had to retract his tweet right away, and you know, he was banned from Twitter for a certain number of hours. He got a pay cut, and there were a lot of ramifications. But this is an example of how it should be. But it doesn't really happen this way. You know, people do not retract. People do not. People are not banned, and you know, and there is no kind of punishment, kind of a thing for putting out false news. So why it happened is because of the, you know, pace at which news develops and the pace at which news is given. But again, the flip side of it is that, you know, in a website, when you will actually see traffic fall if you're not the first to hit the news. So it is always, and the television channels are also into this game where they have to reach there, they have to reach first, and they have to reach fast. So these are some of the pitfalls that journalists will have to kind of, you know, walk the tightrope. And, you know, sacrifice maybe TRP or so for the sake of authentic news.
so much. The last question would be, if you could give a little message to the youth of the channel in this era of social media and news all over, to our viewers.
Well, I have only one advice to tell them, to give them. That is, you know, read, authenticate, re-authenticate. Think before writing or putting out anything on the public domain. Think of the repercussions, think of the fallout that it might have, and recheck again, because if you're caught in this and laws will become only more stringent, there'll be more watchdogs to kind of watch over you. There are already, you know, fact-checkers, fact-checking institutions who are doing that. It's happening in the West. It'll happen here too. And the courts are taking cognizance of each and every offense of such nature. So it is in their interest, it is in the interest of their own careers that they be very careful about what they put out.
That's great, ma'am. Thank you so much for, you know, sharing your time with us and obviously informing our audience with it. Thank you so much, ma'am. Have a great day ahead.
It was a pleasure. Thank you.
We hope that what you have learned in this episode will not be as usual what you would have in a business school. So, as we have come to this last segment of this episode, these are the two quizzes you can answer and win exciting prizes. The first one, what is the fastest source of spreading news on internet? Second, before the whole technology evolved, what was the source of news in the authentic times? So, stay tuned with us, log on to www.mapofme.in, take part in the 26-step challenge. If you have a business plan, submit it to us so that we can help you give a boost to your journey. Stay tuned, stay happy.